Hey, Decope here. Just wanted to shoot this quick video about how I meditate and also why I meditate. So let's first get into the how, because that's pretty important. So before I even get into the meditation itself, I just want to walk you through my morning routine so you can kind of get a feel for where I'm coming from. So when I wake up, I usually need to go to the bathroom, but I want to make my bed first because then I have this sense of urgency because I need to go to the bathroom. So I make my bed really quick, go to the bathroom, and then right after that, I come here and I sit on this couch like this, and I get ready to meditate. So when I move to my couch, I really want to sit on the end of the couch. So I'm sitting on the end of the couch and my back is 90 degrees from the floor. So it's exactly perpendicular to the floor, and then I'm just looking straight ahead, parallel to the floor. My eyes also just parallel to the floor. Then I put my phones into airplane mode so there's no distractions. And I also position my hands slightly inside my knees right here. And with my hands, I just touch my thumbs and my index fingers together to form these two rings, like you see often when you see images of meditation or something. And then I just close my eyes and I purposely relax all the muscles in my body and my face as well. So there's no emotion in my face and all the muscles are just fully relaxed. And then I take deep breaths and I forget everything from the previous day and the previous week and the previous month and year. And I forget all of my problems. I ignore every pain that I'm feeling in that moment, and I just begin to concentrate on my breathing and the breath itself. So I take deep breaths and I concentrate on the air flowing into my lungs and filling like a balloon. And then I'm also breathing through my nose as well. So I inhale through my nose and I exhale seamlessly through my nose to make this consistent rhythm of breath. So it's really important to get that rhythm down. And then at this point, nobody from the outside world can contact me. You know, it's usually from about 7:10 to 7:20 in the morning that I'm gone. I'm unreachable. Decope is not here. He's not in the building. So for those 10 minutes, for all intents and purposes, I don't exist to the world. So I just focus in the moment on replenishing my lungs with the air and the rhythm of the breathing. And my mind naturally begins to wander. So whether it's about what I need to do today or what I want to eat for breakfast or my leg itches or my foot hurts, whatever it is, I just try and ignore everything. And even if there's this huge obstacle that I need to accomplish in that day, like today, then I just ignore it and I focus on my breath and I try and bring it back to my breath. Every time I have these stray ideas, I try and just bring them back. So the focus needs to be so intense that you block out all outside distractions. And you know, if you can't seem to shake a thought or an idea or an impulse that you have, that's when I resort to picturing myself in my cave of isolation, is what I call it. So I start to imagine seeing my breath in the cold air in an icy cave, completely isolated from everyone and everything. So that's basically how I meditate. Now, let me get to why I meditate, because that's also important as well. So I meditate because it increases my attention span and focus. Now, there was an article in 2015 in Time that was highlighting the average person's attention span is down to 8 seconds, and that was back in 2015, so I'm sure it's even less right now. But I started to think about how my attention span was hurting me and other things, and basically I began to look for a solution to these focus problems. And that's when I found meditation actually alleviates some of those feelings of helplessness and uncertainty and anxiety that I was feeling. And I just stumbled upon this idea through research, this idea of meditation, that we can control and direct and train and condition our minds through meditation. So I think it's really important that we talk about that. Now, think about avid moviegoers. So they love going to the movies because it allows them to escape the moment. They're not worried about paying their bills or any of the work they have to do that week for 2 or 3 hours. They're just focused on this movie. So meditation, when done correctly, can bring about these same feelings of relief and escape. And it's free, you know, you don't even have to pay for it. You don't even have to leave your home either. So it's way better than going to a movie, it can be way better than going to a movie. Depends on the movie, I guess. So to meditate is really just to think about nothing and focusing on your breath. So it's important to be able to turn your mind on and off, and that way you can maximize your potential. When you want to be focused on doing a certain task, that's the only thing you're going to be doing. You're going to be focusing on that 100%. So, you know, meditation is supposed to bring inner peace and happiness and balance to your life. And it also has measurable physical benefits that I don't think are talked about enough as well. And it can actually reverse the effects of biological aging. There was a study published in the International Journal of Neuroscience, and it showed that if you had a matching chronological and biological life, and let's say you were 30 years old, and you start meditating every day, well, by the time you're 35, you'll have the skin elasticity and the sexual responsiveness and the auditory threshold and the vision and the memory of a 23-year-old, versus if you didn't meditate, then you'd be like 35 years old. So that's a 13-year difference with just 5 years of meditation. So science has proved that there are huge benefits to meditation, but not everybody knows that. So that's why I'm shooting videos like this. And you know, it's a lot to take in, but the bottom line is when you bring order to your mind, it will do wonders for your health and your work and your life and your relationships. So most of us don't live in isolation, and how we feel has these ripples into our world and all of our daily interactions. And we can inadvertently bring others down with us if we aren't careful. And it's time to get good at meditation so we can get good at everything else. And you know, when you're just starting anything, it's gonna be hard starting out. So when you're starting out, expect to fail. You know, you're not gonna be good at first. Beginners are never good at anything. But with persistence and focus and extreme concentration, you can begin to develop these skills by controlling, directing, training, and conditioning your thoughts until you arrive at that master level. And that's where the meditation can really help you. So the mind is the most powerful computer known to man. The world's fastest supercomputer, running at a full 40 minutes nonstop, can't even compete with 1 second of brain activity. It's not even a close comparison. So the mind is the most powerful computer known to man. And so when you become good at meditating, you'll soon realize you can get good at other things much faster as well. And that's because you're going to possess a greater understanding of the power of focus. And your success really hinges upon your ability to block out all distractions. So there's a saying, if you don't have time to meditate for 10 minutes, then you should be meditating for at least 20 minutes a day. So, and this goes back to planning your day, but that's a whole different video. So that's how you meditate, that's how I meditate, and why I meditate. So if you liked the video, just hit that like button, and I shoot a video like this every week. So if you want to see more videos like this, just click that subscribe button as well, and look forward to seeing you in the next video.